अरुण कुमार उपाध्याय, ही इज एन रिटायर्ड आईपीएस ऑफिसर फ्रॉम उड़ीसा एंड ही हैज डन लॉट ऑफ वर्क ऑन वैदिक साइंसेस. सो आई इनवाइट प्रोफेसर जसवंत सिंह फ्रॉम यूएसए टू इंट्रोड्यूस अवर लर्नेड स्पीकर. प्रोफेसर जसवंत जी.
नमस्ते टू एवरीवन. माय नेम इज जसवंत पटेल, रिटायर्ड प्रोफेसर, बिलोंग्स फ्रॉम ओरिजिनल इन गुजरात, एट प्रेजेंट इन यूएसए. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई से डॉक्टर रवि प्रकाश जी स्टार्ट अ ग्रेट इवेंट. आई विल विश सक्सेस. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस अ स्पीकर, डॉक्टर अरुण उपाध्याय, आईपीएस रिटायर्ड. Dr. Arun Upadhyay, IPS retired, born in 1952 in a family of Vedic traditions of Kashi district. MSc in Physics, 1974. Forestry in 1976. Mathematics in 1981. Read Sanskrit and Vedic books since childhood and pass the प्रचीना मध्यमा फ्रॉम दरभंग संस्कृत यूनिवर्सिटी. आईपीएस इन पंजाब 1974 टू 76. आईपीएस इन ओडिशा 1976 टू 2012. ऑथर ऑफ 10 बुक्स ऑन एस्ट्रोनॉमी, वैदिक साइंस, कैलेंडर, इंडियन क्रोनोलॉजी, structures of language, etc. About 100 papers in seminar and articles in journals on these subjects. He will explain in his speech topic, Science of Agnihotra. It starts with a definition to generalize different meanings and uses of words Agni and Hotra. The definitions include ancient and present practices. Agnihotra is described as the daily practice by each persons, men and women and children, for maintenance of himself, family, society and environment. How it is useful for the modern world in its traditional and modified forms. What are the harm of not following Agnihotra. He will explain everything. Hopefully, I say thanks.
Okay. Arun Upadhyay ji.
First of all, I must thank Dr. Ravi Prakash Arji for inviting me to this learned audience. And I was surprised that Professor Jaswant Singh ji summarized my article very beautifully and correctly. 3 years ago, I had personally met Dr. Ravi Prakash ji in Rohtak University. And in addition to him, I was more impressed with his brother, Dr. Suraj Prakash ji Nadi Vaidya, which is another surprising or miracle thing. Just by touching Nadi, how one can diagnose the disease, which is sometimes undetected by modern methods. So that is another miracle, which is not the subject here. After that, we have not been able to meet due to corona. And in this period, yeah, I suffered twice due to corona. And every time I remembered his brother, Suraj Prakash ji, that how to remain healthy. So in first corona attack, I didn't inform anybody in my family, but for protection of others, I kept aloof from the public contact. And main thing is that we must maintain our breathing normal. By pranayama, I was daily practicing pranayama twice, but reduced my physical activities, asana, etc., due to certain slight weakness due to corona. And within 7 days, I was cured without any medicine. So cough and cold are normal for me. Every year I suffer from cough and cold. So nobody in my family suspected anything bad. And rather I was more afraid of hospital than the corona itself. There is a trouble in hospital. I am not against medicine. Trouble is that if I am admitted for corona, then I will be kept in isolation ward. They may put oxygen cylinder on my mouth and nose, and I would have been unable to do my pranayam, and there is no physical activity. I cannot walk. I cannot do normal exercises. These are the difficulties. And due to isolation, without any contact or verbal or mental contact, one feels suffocated or worried. And that is one of the reasons of death. I have seen that nobody who was not admitted in hospital, nobody such person has died. They suffered from disease, but they didn't die when they were outside hospital. Second time I was coming from Kanpur, so I had to get myself tested, and it was found that it was corona. So I had to take again. Of course, I had to take medicine because corona was officially detected. But I did the same thing, routine pranayam and asanas with slightly lesser intensity. And within 7 days, it was cured. So 7 days is the normal time for curing of normal cough or cold or corona if there is no other serious disease. I am not against medical science or any method. But for normal persons, this is the best method. Similarly, about yajna, there are a lot of confusion, and it is considered a miracle because we don't understand any of the aspects fully as per the scientific methods. So it is still a miracle. And I have tried to analyze them as a mathematician or physicist, means how to generalize it, which is the method of Vedas. In Vedic literature, meaning of all words are generalized, like Agni, Hotra, and about Yajna itself, there are many classifications. The Three Upanishad classifies in 5 into 5 groups, Panktineva, Panktang, Pranuti. Mundaka Upanishad, Katha Upanishad, they describe in 18 types of Yajnas. Gita, chapter 3, describes 14 types of yajna. Then what is yajna? Then worst meaning and totally incorrect translation is sacrifice. Yajna doesn't mean any sacrifice or any killing of animals. So this is a rather mischievous translation of yajna in English by calling it sacrifice. It is not a sacrifice. It is actually reverse of sacrifice. We are producing something by yajna. So I have tried the axiomatic method, which is called in mathematics, axiomatic approach. Definition, description, or mathematical formulation, and experiments. So what are the miracles of yajna? First, I'm coming to that. We are in normal ritual, or what we call karma kand. We recite some mantras, offer some things in fire, and so we get some results. So how we are getting result, that is still a secret or mystery. One explanation is that the vibration of mantras creates some effect within our mind or in the atmosphere. This is one explanation. And that also works. Another explanation may be that by regular habit of rituals, we are molding our life into a regular lifestyle, and that keeps us healthy both mentally and physically. If we maintain a regular lifestyle, that is a broader aspect of Agnihotra or any karmakanda. Then sound effect. In 1985, I had cancer. It was related to nervous system. So doctors in Medical College of Cuttack, they told that it is incurable. They referred me to Tata Institute of Mumbai. So I asked whether it will be cured. They told it will not be cured because it is related to nervous system. So I thought over it. Then why I should go to Bombay? I will try it myself. Then because it was related to nervous system, I tried Kundalini Yoga. Kundalini Tantra, Satyanand Yoga Vidyala, there is a book. Shivanand also has written Kundalini Tantra, but Satyanand, his disciple, has written it in more practical way. So he had given 8 months course. I was doubtful whether I will survive for 8 months. So I reduced it to 4 months. And within 4 months, the tumor was became very small, and there was no pain at all. It was almost cured. And then slowly it vanished. So when Priyajog method, I tried sound effect also. There is a saying in Vedas, Chakshu Surjo Ajayata Purushuk, the daily worship you tell. So one professor came to meet me. He was almost blind due to glaucoma. He was also told by doctor that it is incurable. Then I tried. I told him that I will do experiment with you. You have nothing to lose because you are already blind. So he agreed. So I told him that Surj is rang. I explained him a method how to practice rang bijma. Only one word, one letter. Rang is in common terms, it becomes Ram in the common language. So by practicing rang bij mantra, which is called, even in modern medicine, it is called solar plexus. In navel region, Manipur chakra is region of sun, which controls the eyesight also as per Chakshusho Upanishad. Or rather, Purushukta also, Chakshusho Ajayata. So within 1 month, he was able to see and able to read the broad letters, large size letters. So he was almost working. It was not perfectly normal, but he was able to see and do all his words. So this is the effect of sound or vibration. And there are some sequences which chakras are related to which word. Then there is another thing, Harimana Prithivya Mantra in Rig Veda. Surya Upanishad tells that it cures asthma. If you read it in that context, the first mantra of Yajurved, that also tells Ayakshma Bhavantu. Then how it is done? Ishetva Urjetva Vayavastha. What is Isha in context of human body? It is spinal cord or the central nerve in the spinal cord. What is Vayu? Vayavastha Urja. Means you move the Vayavastha Urja, prana energy, in the chakras of spinal cord, which is Ishadan, and it will be cured. And you will be cured from Akshma, Anamiva. Anamiva is a Greek word, also has the same meaning, amoeba, amoebasis. So you will be free of an amoeba, free of asthma. So in a way, Yajurveda first mantra also explains the method, but that way nobody has translated it or explained it. So these are the methods of curing ourselves. Then I am coming to the general meaning and classification of yajnas. Gita is called Ved Prasthan or Vedant Darshan Prasthan by all the Vedant Acharyas. Prasthan means it is the best method to approach the meaning of Vedas. Basically, it gives definition of all the terms. For that, it is most useful book. So Gita has defined in 8th chapter, at start of 8th chapter, three world systems and three processes. Three world systems are cosmic system, how world is moving or created in the space. Then physical system on earth, how the creation on earth is behaving or functioning. Then within human body. So all are image of each other. That in a sense that is obvious because Earth was created in space. So it has to obtain some qualities of space. human body is created in earth, so we are inheriting some properties of earth and outer space also. In Bible first chapter itself, it is told that God created man after his own image. There are many methods of similarities. I will quote only one, which is very surprising. Satva Brahman chapter 12 tells that how human body is image of universe. There are 100 billion galaxies in universe. Our galaxy contains 100 billion stars, and our human mind contains 100 billion neurons. That calculation is done. It comes to around 100 billions. So Earth is image of galaxy and the whole universe, whole visible universe, because all are having same number of particles. Here neurons are particles in our brain. For galaxy, stars are particles, and for the whole space, galaxy itself is a particle. So there is nothing peculiar or unique about so-called God particle, which is a common word these days. Even galaxy is considered a particle in all the modern or ancient cosmology theories. So these are the systems of world systems. There are other classifications also, 13 classifications, I will not go into that. Then there are three processes. First is Brahma. Brahma means everything, whether it's internal or motion is seen or unseen, with what we call in physics virtual motion within atoms, etc. Then karma. Karma means action. It means same thing which is called work in terms of physics. Any motion, that is called jagat aspect. Jagat means gatishil motion. So motion can be arbitrary, it can be destructive also. The motion or action which creates useful things in cycles, that is called yajna. So all are subset of the earlier. Karma is one part of Brahma. It also pervades the whole universe. Yajna also pervades the whole universe. What is useful yajna? So generally yajnas are of three types, which are related to the natural cycles of time. Some are daily yajnas, which is axial rotation of earth. Some are monthly yajnas, which is synodic revolution of moon. And some are annual yajnas, which is related to orbital motion of Earth, orbital cycle of Earth. There are smaller cycles also, like pranayam yajna, that is the smallest natural cycle for human beings. Means we can think of other smaller cycles also, but for our life, human life, prana or breathing cycle is the smallest. And there are two yajnas related to prana cycle. One is called prana yajna, another is called pranayam yajna. And it is peculiar, means no commentary on Gita has explained the difference between these two. What is prana yajna, pranayam yajna? Pranayam yajna, normally it is considered that we control the breathing, we make it smooth and natural. And there are several types of pranayam, but it regulates our digestion, thought process, and it calms our mind. Then what is prana yajna? Prana and apana yajna. Prana is intake of energy, apana is output. We must maintain balance between the two. We should get something as food energy, we should spend it also. Otherwise we will become sick if we don't use or spend our energy. So both positive and negative, means input and output, should be maintained in a regular manner. Nothing should exceed the normal in usual course. So if you maintain the input and output cycle, that is prana yajna. There are seven levels which I will not go into it. So these are the Brahma, Karma and Yajna. So what is Agnihotra? Agni also has several meanings. Agni doesn't mean that we should burn a fire and start worshipping it or saluting it or any type of devotion to a fire. This is not the meaning of Agni. Even the first verse of Rig Veda indicates several types of Agnim Ile Purohitam. What is Purohitam? Pura means front, Hitam means welfare. anybody or anything which comes in front of me and does work for me is Purohit. Like an advocate is my Purohit. A leader is my Purohit. It is more specifically told in the last chapter of Yajurveda. Agne Naya Supatha Raye. Means he is leader which leads us to for on correct path. So because it leads Naya Raye, so all the navigators in coastal district of coastal area of Kerala and even in northwest part of Punjab, etc., they are called Nayar in Punjab, Nayar in Kerala. I learned that Nayars were navigators, which fits the definition of Ishavasya Upanishad, Agne Naya Supatha Raye. In ocean, they were leading to the correct path as a navigator, so they are called Nayar. So these meanings were popular all over the world, which I will not give example. So this is one meaning, and specifically it is defined in Shatpat Brahman that Agri means Agni. Agri was indirectly called Agri means Agrani, leader. So in context of space, what is Agri? First Agri is the Brahma itself, abstract form of God. Second Agri is the collection of galaxy. What is Agri? It some parts of matter condensed. So condensed form of matter or energy is called Agni. What is fire? It is condensed form of heat in a compact form, you can say. So there are five levels of condensation which are called five Agnis in space. First level of condensation is galaxies. Second level is stars within galaxy. Third level is planets within solar system. Fourth level is the habitable zone of planetary system. Fifth level is Earth itself. It is written that Akashad Vayu. Akash is the open space, infinite space, whose density is minimum, so it is almost vacant, so it is called Akash. Motion has started from galaxy. So it is called Vayu, motion, Akashad Vayu. Vayu Agni. Agni is sun. Agni Apa. Apa is the spread matter at various levels. So Apa, from Apa, moon and sun, other planets were created. Adhya Prithvi, from Apa, Earth was created. Prithvibhyang Oshadhya. All these are symbolized in the Kalas Puja, Kalas Sthapan, before start of any worship. Kalas includes all the forms, and Adhya Prithvya Oshadhya, then life started. So as symbol of Oshadhya, we put mango leaves. So, and the mantra itself also tells Hiranyagarbha Samvarta Tagre Bhutasya Jata. It indicates the process of creation. So, these are the Agnis in space.